The cell is the basic unit of life, and all cells must be spatially organized. For example, for a cell to divide, it must find its center. Animal cells achieve this by assembling a pair of radial structures called asters. In the textbook model, each aster is made by making microtubules from central points in the cell. Where the two asters meet, the cell divides. Now, try building a very large aster, so large that it can fill up the millimeter-sized frog egg. Frog eggs are one of the largest cells found in nature and are 100 times larger than your average skin cell. Due to the radial geometry of asters, we expect a low density of microtubules at the periphery. However, the asters inside frog eggs look quite bushy. How can we explain this? In a previous paper, we found that microtubules are also made throughout the aster. In the current paper, we used mathematical modeling to test our new model of aster growth. The two ingredients are, first, the microtubule growing and shrinking. Second, a pre-existing microtubule making a new microtubule, which we call self-amplification. Our model predicted two possibilities, an aster that remains constant in radius versus an aster that grows continuously. Surprisingly, we found that the whole aster can grow even when individual microtubules are short and disappearing. For this to happen, a microtubule needs to make at least one new microtubule before it disappears. Here's an analogy. In a relay race, there's no one on your team who has to run the entire race. But to finish, you have to pass the baton to the next runner before you can stop. In summary, if microtubules self-amplify, no single microtubule has to be super long. Under our newly proposed collective growth model, even short microtubules as a group can make a large structure with unlimited size. For more information, please check out our full story.